Hi guys, welcome back, and today I'm going to show you how to do special effects in KineMaster. So basically, I'm going to show you how to do muzzle flashes, gunshots, bullet holes, and put it into your movie. So first, film yourself like you're in some action. So I have two Nerf guns. I have this small revolver that shoots one shot and this machine gun. So we're gonna start easy by doing the single shot and then increasing by doing the machine gun. So we can track the muzzle flash to your gun. Just quickly, today's shout out goes to Destroyer X Gaming. Thank you so much for being active and shout out to you. I always find these effects to be better if it's on green screen. Obviously, we open KineMaster first. Then click create project, 16:9. And then we're gonna go to media and get the little action clip that we have. Now I'm going to choose the part that we need. Then click trim split. Then click split that playhead. And we're going to delete the unnecessary parts. So now we have this clip with three shots. Obviously there's no effects on it yet. So now we're going to checkmark this. Then go to layer. Now click all. And now we're going to get the muzzle flash. First we need to remove the green screen. Then click chroma key. Then click enable. And now the green screen is gone. And the muzzle flash is kind of facing me, so we have to change that. We're gonna click rotate. And now we're gonna click this. Instead of facing right, it's gonna face left. Now adjust it to where the muzzle flash is supposed to be. Check mark. Now we're gonna click blending. Normally, it's adjusted to normal, but I'm gonna click screen. And click check mark. So now we have one shot. Now mark the clip, and then we're gonna get another copy of this muzzle flash. So click duplicate. Then mark the clip again, and click duplicate. And of course, the other ones adjusted as well. If you need to change their rotation slightly or anything. Usually, I would go to audio and get the gunshot sound effect, but I do not have the sound effect, so I'm just gonna edit as an additional layer. So I'm gonna click layer, then media, then click all, and now I'm gonna get the sound effect. And here's my picture, but it has a sound effect. So first, we don't want my picture to be there, so we're gonna click alpha opacity and reduce it to zero. So now it'll only leave the sound. So now we have the first shot sound, and now we're just gonna duplicate it. And now we're gonna duplicate it again. Now when we play, here's the effect. So there you go, not too bad, right? Now I'll show you with the machine gun, because it takes a few extra steps. We're just gonna open new project, and now we're gonna get the machine gun clip, obviously. Obviously, you're gonna do the same thing and cut all the unnecessary parts. You see, the thing with a machine gun is moving a lot, so it's a little bit complicated. And now I'm gonna add the muzzle flash, but it already has a sound. The point is, I'm gonna show you how to track the muzzle flash to the gun. And the reason it has sound is because it's faster to edit, and plus I already showed you. And the great thing about this is it already has bullets flying off the gun, which is great. So of course, same thing here, remove the green screen. And we're gonna flip it as well because it's facing the opposite side. There you go. For this one, zoom in as much as you can to the timeline. Because we have to be very specific where the muzzle flash is. So it's actually gonna move with the machine gun. This is a good starting point. You could put blend mode to screen as well. Usually it works better. So mark the muzzle flash clip. Go to where the muzzle flash is in the beginning. And go to the left and click the key on the left. And then on the right, under animation, it says it has a circle with a plus sign, so you click that. And now on the bottom, it added a keyframe. So now every time your gun moves, you have to move the muzzle flash with it. And rotate it occasionally too. I'm gonna do a little bit of it, and then I'll come back and show you. And also, every time you move the muzzle flash, the keyframes are automatically added. I already exported it, so I'm gonna play it now. You see the muzzle flash follows the gun. And now we're doing the bullet hole effect and we're using a tripod. It's way easier on a tripod because the bullet hole stays in place. If the camera moves, then you're gonna have to track the bullet hole to a specific point, and that's a little more complicated. That's why we're doing this easier on the tripod. So now click layer, then click media. Now we're gonna get the clip of the bullet hole. It could be a picture of a bullet hole, but this one, it has like dust and sparks, so it's good. So same story, remove the green screen. Obviously, this bullet hole is not gonna be on me or the couch. We're gonna position it on the wall. And we're gonna make it bigger just for appearance. Now when you play, the bullet hole is gonna appear. Like that. Thank you so much for watching today's video. This was a quick video. I just wanted to give you a quick idea of how to do muzzle flashes, bullet holes, and gunshots. If you need any other KineMaster tutorials, click this playlist. I have many different videos in this playlist.